Yeah. Okay, so let's look at this one right here. I know there's a video out there, but we will talk about it together just to make sure. Okay. All right. We're supposed to determine whether that we converge or diverge, and if it converges, what does it converge to?
It converges.
Alright, so I know I'm an improper integral because I can do what? What do I see?
Infinity.
I see the infinity, so I'm not improper, so I have to convert to the limit. As the approaches infinity, I'm going to go put the sub down in front and bring this upstairs by making the exponent of what?
Negative.
Okay, so we're back to real basic integration. We've got the limit as b approaches infinity. When I integrate x to the negative 2, what do I get? From negative 2, got it. From 4 to b. Alright, then you get the limit as b approaches infinity. This has to go back downstairs, right? Before I can plug in. So that's negative 7 over 2x squared. I've got the limit as b approaches infinity of negative 7 over 2b squared minus negative 7 over 1c squared. 116 plus 2 is what?
32.
Okay, so that's going to go positive. Am I okay to go ahead and put my infinity in? So negative 7 over 2 times infinity squared plus 7 over 32. What is 7 divided by infinity?
Zero.
So 7 over 32 is our answer. It converges, and it's 7 over 32. Okay. So this next one says, determine whether the improper integral converges or diverges. Evaluate the integral if it converges. Okay, so I'm going to start. How do we know it's improper?
Infinity.
So we're going to go limit as b approaches infinity from 0 to b of x e to the negative 1 fifth x dx. Okay.
Integration.
It's integration by parts, okay? And you have a choice of doing it by the straightforward parts, or we can do tabular parts. Well, I'm going to remind ourselves. So this is the sine, right? And then this is the u, and then this is the dv part. So what would you pick for the u? X. And it is the derivative of x is 1, and the derivative of 1 is 0. So that's going to go down. And then we've got e to the negative 1 fifth x. Right? So negative 1 fifth. Right. So when I integrate that, what am I going to need?
The negative 5.
The negative 5 is roughly 2 separate.
Yes.
So it's really this du equals negative 1 fifth dx. So on every single one, we've got to sub, we've got to put a negative 5 over x. That's p to the negative 1 fifth x. And then so on the next interval of it, what would I get?
25.
Yeah. Okay. Then our sign, we always start positive, negative, positive, right? Okay, so then to the answer, okay, is we go across and then down and across and then down. I still have my limit. I have not done that for yet. All I did was, this just took care of the entire integration. So I got x, negative 5, e to the negative 1, e of x. Then across here, I thought another negative, so that's my arrow. Okay? So minus 1 times 25, e to the negative 1, e of x. I'm going to sub in and I'm going to
stuff down too. Limit as b approaches infinity, negative 5 b over b to the negative 1/5 b of positive 1/5 minus 25 over b to the 1/5 b minus. When I put 0 into this first part, what do I get? 0. I put a 0 into the second part again. I have e to the 0, which is
1
times the 25, which is negative 1. Okay. Can I sub an infinity into this thing right here? I get infinity over infinity, don't I? So what do I need to do? We have to do the L'Hopital's rule first. Okay? So we've got the limit as b approaches infinity. And then when I either, or when I take the derivative of the top, what do I get? Negative 5 over 1. So e to the 1/5, right? And the chain rule give me a 1/5 out front again. And then the back part, it's positive. All right, this piece here, I only have to go to the L'Hopital in the front piece, because this piece I can put an infinity into, can't I? Yeah, so I'm only doing the limit on this first piece here. This piece here, when I invoke the limit on it, I get negative 25 over b to the infinity power, right?
Yeah.
Which becomes what? The whole thing becomes what? 0. And then we've got a plus 25 to that. Infinity of 25 divided by infinity. 0. A small number divided by a giant number. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and put the infinity into this one here. Okay, so we've got negative 5 over 1/5 e to the infinity again, plus 25, so what's this piece here going to be? 0, so my final answer is? Improper again, what's different about this improper?
Oh, we have to split it up.
We have to split it up. Where's our convenient value to split it up at?
Zero.
So we're going to go negative infinity to 0. Yes. Right now, it's going to be for these particular ones, if I pull the multiple choice right from here, yes. Is it fair game to not put it there? Yes. We can be expecting a request. Both. Yes. Okay. You see an infinity, you're going to automatically go from there. Okay, so any type of seed infinity. I may not pull out the ones, remember the ones where we have where it was the last set, the second day we did it, we had the vertical tangent stuff. I don't think that's going to Okay. You can leave, that's one for the other. Okay? Alright, 225 plus x squared dx, then from 0 to infinity of 5 over 225 plus x squared dx. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and do our limits. So the limit as we approach, no, I can't do the limit of a, right? As a approaches negative infinity, I'm going to go from a to 0, and then I'm going to go ahead and pull that 5 out front. Now 1 over 225 plus x squared dx plus the limit as b approaches infinity from 0 to b. Put the 5 out front again, 1 1 over a squared plus a squared, what am I going to do? R2. If you need to know that for the test, I'm not going to have it anymore for you. Okay, at some point you've got to memorize it. We might as well put it out. Okay. So we've got the limit as a approaches negative infinity. Okay, so when I do arctangent and I integrate, so you need to know this for the test. What has to go out in front of the arctangent? It's going to be the 5 that's already there over the a value, right? So it's, I think it's 1 over a, isn't it?
Yeah.
So the a value is 15. And then it's 1 in the middle over inside the tangent. Yeah, the whatever this variable is over the number, so x over 15. And from a to 0. We have the exact same thing back here, right? Except that it's going to go from 0 to b. So the limit as b approaches infinity of 5 over 15 over tangent x over 15. Likely to see the arctangent one because remember we memorized and then the pi over 2 thing, right? So we've got the limit as a approaches negative infinity. I'm plugging in my a, my 0 and my a, and I reduce it to 1/3. Arctangent of 0 minus 1/3 arctangent of a. Plus the limit as b approaches infinity of 1/3 arctangent of b over 15 minus 1/3 arctangent of 0. Okay, what's the arctangent to 0? What's 0 supposed to look like? I'm going to go ahead and plug in my infinities. Negative 1/3 arctangent of negative infinity over 15 plus 1/3 arctangent of infinity over 15. Okay. What do I get with for arctangent of negative, basically of negative? Tangent of infinity is pi over 2. We put the negative in there and we get the inverse pi over 2. Okay. 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 Yeah. And then we've got the arctangent of, so the arctangent of infinity again is what? Pi over 2. All right, and then the double negative here is going to go into positive. I'm going to cancel. So let's see, I've seen pi over 6 plus pi over 6. So pi over 6 plus pi over 6 would be
2 and pi over 6.
Pi over
3.
3, which would have to be this one here, right? So it converges to that. To a 6 over x minus 8 squared dx any good. It's going to get me a 1, isn't it? It's technically we have a u sub there, but it would be just a dx, so there's no point in actually doing a u sub, right? Alright, I would probably take this and bring it upstairs. How do I do that? Turn the exponent negative, so a, I'm going to go ahead and pull the 6 out front. 7 to a of x minus a to the negative 2 dx. Same thing over here. Limit as b approaches a of 6 to 9 of x minus a to the negative 2 dx. As a approaches 8, what do I have to do to the exponent to integrate? Add 1. That's 6. X minus 8 to the what power? Negative 1 divided by negative 1, or can I just pull the negative out for it? 7 to a. The same thing here. The bit as b approaches 8. That's 6. X minus 8. At the same time I'm subbing in, I'm going to go ahead and move this downstairs, okay? I haven't taken my limit yet. Okay, good question. We've got negative 6 over this mess here, and I'm just substituting an a, so a minus 8. Minus negative 6 over, I put the 7 into this, so it's 7 minus 8. Negative 1 is supposed to go positive right here. Plus the limit as b approaches 8, negative 6 over. Let's see, what's 9 minus 8? 1. So minus negative 6 over b minus 8. Catch that, you have to put the direction on. Okay. When I put the 8 in, okay, let's kind of look at the direction that it's approaching. Okay, because if I put an 8 in, what's going to happen to my denominators? I'm going to go to 0, right? I could do L'Hopital's rule. Okay? That's going to get me a 0 on the top and a 0 and get me just a number on the bottom. So I'm not sure that's really going to do me much good. So I kind of need to look at what's happening as I'm approaching it. So as I'm coming at 8 from the left side, what number would you put in there? 7, right? The left side. Yeah, so 7 and things that are getting really, really close to 8, right? So 7.555, 7.999, 7.9999, right? So what's that going to do? So if I'm basically getting about, I'm getting 1 or almost a 0 at the bottom. So which is growing faster, the numerator or the denominator? The numerator, so what's that going to turn this thing into? Ultimately. Right. And this is going to be insignificant. What's this one going to go to if I do the same thing from the other side? Yeah. So, when I have infinity plus infinity, what happens? Yes.
Is that negative?
It's the 8. is from the left side of the right side, if that makes sense. I'm sorry. Okay. After you all your hymnals. Some of that's more challenging than others. No, it's not. You guys are not the worst I've ever seen.
No.
plus and I negative 2 is? Just natural log of 2. 0 minus 1 is? Absolutely negative 1 is? Natural log of 1 is? I'm going to go ahead and sub my infinities in, so I end up with the natural log of infinity, which is minus the natural log of infinity, which is infinity, which still technically is infinity of rho. Is it indeterminate or determinate? Yeah. configuration by four. Yes. Don't need to do that one. Okay. There is not that exact one. Probably should do that. But isn't that the one where we had the little nifty little formula? So, you guys need to make sure you know that properly, okay? So, we need to identify, what's our p-value on the 6?
6.
6, okay.
6 is greater than 1.
Greater than 1, so what does that mean? Does it converge or diverge? It converges, okay. So we need to figure out what it converges to.
So it's 13.
Okay, so it's 1 over, what is it? P minus 1, which is 1 over 6 minus 1, which is 1/5. If you didn't remember that, then we fall back on our improper interval sum.
Yes.
Okay, so you could go the limit as p approaches infinity, 1 to be x to the negative 6 dx. And then when we integrate that, we get the limit of h in 7. X to the negative 5 from negative 5. And then the limit as p approaches infinity. Let's take a problem with that. X is smiley face, is x equal to smiley face and x equal to x instead?
Yeah, zero.
Alright, so expect me to throw a couple of things in there that you may not have seen in a while. And that's not, it's not bad to practice something like that because the AP test.
Well, we're just learning some good facts and learning some good. Let's go way back.
Rachel, my senior year of college, all I did, all I worked in was there, because I have three majors, so all I worked in was there. I'm sure if I took out that paper, I'd sink it.